So I am now 40. I'm about to be 41 weeks. Hello, welcome back to my channel. I know it has been such a long time since the last time I posted. I believe it was a little over a month ago now. Don't mind me, I'm just pouring water into my cup. But yeah, I haven't posted in such a long time, and pregnancy's hard, okay? It's
You could do so.
Pregnancy's rough, okay? It really got to me the last month. I just wanted to make this video kind of raw. Honestly, I'm at the very late stage in my pregnancy. We're actually expecting to have our baby boy very, very soon with us. So I did want to post one last video before he makes like his arrival. So he'll be here super, super soon. It's just a matter of being patient at this point and just waiting for that day. I don't know what life's gonna be like. It's completely gonna change. You know, I know I'm not gonna have this much time. You know, it's funny, I was actually just speaking with Nathan earlier today, and when I go to the restroom now, like, my stomach just feels so heavy. So I sit there for so many minutes at a time, and I really take my time. And lately I've just been thinking, you know, this is gonna be the last few times I get to do this. Or I've really been enjoying my showers, taking longer showers, like honestly 15-20 minute showers, just enjoying the water and like the time to myself, because I know once baby boy is here, I'm not gonna have, you know, that time anymore. It's gonna be like I'm living for him. So anyway, back to my pregnancy related things. So my original due date, when I first like went to the doctor I'm seeing now, was November 26th, and then they moved it to November 19th. And so I always stuck with November 19th, somewhere in between, you know, when I saw the doctor very early, and the visits that I would go and see her, you know, one time a month, somewhere in there, they switched it back to November 26th. So I was just always stuck on November 19th. November 19th, that's the date that I shared with my job. That's the date that I shared with my friends and family. It was just known to, I guess to me, November 19th. Well, November 19th came, and no, I was considered to be 39 weeks when I went for my doctor's visits. And at this point, I was going weekly, you know, so that was fine. I just had to be patient. I was like, you know what? It's okay. One more week and we'll have our baby here. No, no, that wasn't the case. My body just, I was 1 centimeter dilated since I believe 37, 38 weeks. So that's good news. But I thought after being 1 centimeter that I would easily, you know, progress to 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters. Like, as a first-time mom, that's just what I thought would happen. And believe me, like, I've read millions and millions of stories. Well, not millions, right? I'm exaggerating. Believe me, I've read so many stories of different types of labor. I try not to traumatize myself, you know? So, while every pregnancy is different, and you know, how you all bring your children into this world is your own experience, I just don't want to scare myself more than I'm already kind of anxious, you know? So I don't want to scare myself, and I don't try to read the bad experiences. I try to read ones that are positive. I've never really had like a full out birth plan. I've always known, you know, I'm gonna do whatever I gotta do. If that means a C-section last minute, so be it. If that means I have to be induced, so be it. You know, I don't feel any less having to do those two things. So anyway, I read and read and read on all of that, and I read, you know, that after you are told you're 1 centimeter, it basically means nothing. Doesn't mean I'm gonna progress the next day to 2, or in a week he's gonna be here. I've just learned it's literally on the baby's time. I knew I wasn't gonna immediately start dilating, you know, and get to where I was supposed to be. I knew it could take some time, but I was at 1 centimeter literally for weeks. I would walk, people would tell me go walking a lot, and doctors told me to use the birth ball, which I did buy like the last month of my pregnancy. So I bought that and I was using that, not consistently, to be honest. I used it for about a week, 2 weeks consistently. That was just like an hour a day that I did. And then it got to be a little bit too much. I was just feeling a lot of pressure. And that's kind of about the point where I was like, you know what? It's on his timing. I was just frustrated because I was doing so much. I was walking around in my home. I was doing the birth ball. There came a week, I believe I was 39 weeks, when I really thought I was gonna have him that week right before Thanksgiving. And I was following all these videos on YouTube. I was doing like the miles circuit, and that's where you do 3 different activities like for 30 minutes at a time, but you're literally like flipping your body over and different things. I'm embarrassed about it now, but at the time, like, I really thought that's what would help put me into labor. I did like a labor activating video that was kind of going around in the discussions that I follow, and a lot of women were saying that that was helping, that they were going into labor the next day, in 2 days, that same night they were getting contractions, all this different stuff. So I really thought that was going to work for me. And then when my doctor's visit came that week and I was still at 1 centimeter, she was very encouraging, but that's when I had to accept, you know, it's not on my timing. It's when the baby's ready. I also don't want to like force this baby out and something go wrong. You know, it's definitely taught me patience. It's taught me that it's God's timing. It's the baby's timing, and he'll be here when he's meant to be here. So fast forward to, you know, I guess now, we're in December. It's December 1st, and he is officially going to be a December baby, and I'm completely fine with that. I've accepted it. I was bummed in the beginning, and, you know, people just keep asking you, like, when are you gonna have the baby? Is the baby here yet? And I'm completely thankful to have people around us like that, you know, that are just as anxious to meet the baby. But I kind of blame myself for sticking to that November 19th date, because now it's been so many weeks after that and people are like, hello, when are you gonna give birth? Hello, where's the baby? So that's been a little, not rough, I don't wanna say rough. It's just been consistent, you know, people just always asking, and I feel like I'm letting them down is what I feel like. But at this point, I'm just saying, you know, he's gonna be here this week, and I'm thankful for that. We're gonna meet him very, very soon, and that's really all I want. Me and Nathan have so many discussions, you know, about this moment, and now that it's getting here, like, we're super anxious. Not really nervous, it's more like we're just excited and we want to meet him, you know, but at the same time, like, we completely understand that life's gonna change. We're ready for it, but also not. And I say not just in the sense that, like, I feel like the second we bring the baby home, like, I'm gonna forget. Which I know people are gonna be like, oh, like, your mother instinct, like, kicks in and stuff. And I completely believe that. It's just, you know, it's just the nerves kicking in. So I'm excited. We're both very excited, me and Nathan. In the beginning, I think he was super nervous. And anytime I would get contractions or I would be feeling pain, and I would share with Nathan, like, oh, you know, like, my stomach hurts, or rub my back, like, this doesn't feel right, blah, blah, blah. He would always get a little nervous, and he would always make jokes, like, to the baby, you know, to stay in me, stay in my tummy, wait another week. I think he's just trying to prolong it, you know, and now that it's here, especially last week, he's really understood and, like, been kissing my belly more and more, you know, and like we both speak to the baby more and more in my belly, and we just tell him, you know, we're ready for you. We have so many people that are waiting for you. We have all of his stuff ready for him, you know, from the outfits, the room, the blankets, the amount of blankets we have for him. We're just so ready. It's such an exciting time, and I just life's gonna change. We even lay down all the time, and Nate's always the one to bring up, you know, we're gonna have a baby right in between us now. It's not just gonna be me and you. I also got off the phone with my dad earlier today. I was just updating him on how my doctor's appointment went today. And the last thing he told me was like, you know, oh, enjoy your last days as a single woman. Obviously not single, but you know, I know what he meant. Like as a, not a mom, not an official mom yet. So now it's just about praying, you know, everything goes well. If, you know, God willing, we will have our baby boy here by the end of the week. And I'm just so ready. I keep saying that, but it's such an exciting time. Like, you know, you imagine this baby in your head, this life that I've created, that I've had in my belly for 9 months. And it's just exciting to see, like, who's he gonna look like? Me, more like me, more like Nathan. It's gonna be half of us, you know, half of each of us. He's gonna have little traits that are Nathan, some that are mine. And it's just really, really amazing. It's beautiful. It is. I'm excited. So with all that being said, I'm just going to end the video here. I did want to give just this update, you know, because my last video was strictly on planning and during pregnancy, and I've completely stopped. I haven't kept up with the planning. I've really just been resting because my body was beginning to swell, and I've had to drink more water. I've just been enjoying this time, this quiet time, I guess, before the baby's actually here, just prepping and getting ready. I will end the video here. Like I said, if you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. It means so, so much to me. I will see you all in my next video. Bye.